Welcome back, I'm that chemist. And my voice cracked. Welcome back, I'm that chemist. Welcome back, I'm that chemist. And today we're going to be deciding which chemical has the worst abbreviation. So let's get started. Here we have the Bach group. When you're installing the Bach group to stuff, you use this chemical called Bach anhydride. Now, you might be thinking this one kind of looks like a chicken. It's got a chicken foot, that's why it Bachs. And this group is used in protecting amino groups. Occasionally, you'll also see it protecting alcohol groups. Now, protecting in chemistry is like, you don't want a certain part of a molecule to do stuff, so you just kind of block it, and then you take off the blocking agent thing afterwards. So Bach, it's not too terrible of an abbreviation. It's kind of annoying. It's not very terrible. So I think we could probably put it in C tier. So for this tier list, the abbreviations that are the most cringe are going to go into F tier. And the best abbreviations are going to go into S tier. So if it's based, it's S tier, and if it's cringe, it's F tier. Next we have TIPS chloride. TIPS chloride is Triisopropylsilyl chloride. This is just like a big bulky group. This is another protecting group that people put onto alcohol groups in total synthesis. And so I think we can stick its TIPS into A tier, but we're going to put it in B tier. This one's not too bad because it's just TIPS. It's a little bit funny. But it's not, it's not too terrible of an abbreviation, all things considered. Next, we have MOM chloride. This stands for methoxymethyl chloride. And you might be thinking, Mom, can I have a chloride? And, you know, Mom says, we have chloride at home, and this is the chloride that we have at home. So this is another reagent that's like a protecting group. I'm actually not sure if you've noticed this, but the three that we've covered so far are all protecting groups. This is one that's kind of annoying to install, and it's also horrendously toxic. In fact, it's listed as a Group 1 carcinogen by the International Agency for Research on Cancer. And if you're wondering what Group 1 means, it means that it's confirmed to be carcinogenic to humans. And it's almost as toxic as your mom. Why don't we put mom chloride into E tier? Next, we have CAMP. This is cyclic adenosine monophosphate. I'll make it bigger here so you can see it. CAMP is a secondary messenger, which is important in many biological applications, and it's used for intracellular signaling transduction in many different organisms. Now, you might be thinking that this belongs in fat CAMP. Why don't we put CAMP into, like, C tier? Again, it's not too bad. And I'm going to leave it all derpy because reasons. Here we have TPAP. This stands for Tetrapropylammonium perruthenate. You might have heard of permanganate, but you can even have perruthenate, which is a ruthenium atom. This is an oxidant that converts alcohols to aldehydes and ketones. This is known as the Ley oxidation. This is a really good oxidant, but it's so expensive that your PIs don't like if you use it because it has ruthenium in it, super duper expensive. And you might be thinking, TPAP? Don't smear it all over yourself. Terrible idea. TPAP, this one's actually pretty annoying. I really dislike the name of TPAP, so why don't we put it into E tier? Also, don't look too long at that symbol. It's just a tetrapropyl ammonium, but yeah, just don't look at that. Don't stop. No, I said, what are you doing? Okay, FOOF. Dioxygen difluoride. This oxidant is super powerful, and it slowly decomposes to oxygen and fluorine, basically no matter what, even if it's at minus 160 degrees Celsius. This chemical reacts with almost any other chemical that it encounters, and the way it's formed is by exposing a mixture of oxygen and fluorine to an electrical discharge, which is pretty wild. Alternatively, you can cool them to minus 196 degrees Celsius and expose them to Bremsstrahlung, which is known as breaking radiation, and I haven't heard about this before, and I don't know too much about it. How much Bremsstrahlung? 3 mega electron volts. And guess what? This chemical foofs everything it touches. I really like foof. I think foof can stay in S tier. Foof is based. Now, DABCO. DABCO is 1,4-diazabicyclo-222-octane, and this is a nucleophilic tertiary amine base that's used as a base catalyst for a lot of different applications. One chemical that's made from DABCO is this reagent called SelectFluor, which is an electrophilic fluorinating agent. Super common in research, you see it all the time at fluorine conferences. And DABCO is also used for the Bayliss-Hillman reaction. Why don't we dab DABCO into D tier? Because it starts with a D. Next, starting with a D once again, we have DEADCAT, also known as diethyl azodicarboxylate. Usually people refer to this as DEAD, but you see it also referred to as DEADCAT quite often. This is used in the Mitsunobu reaction in conjunction with triphenylphosphine. It's a really useful reaction in synthetic chemistry, and people have moved away from dead to dyad because they don't want to be dead. There's been issues where this chemical is a little bit unstable and it poses an explosion risk. There are other reactions that DEADCAT can do, such as feed a grizzly. Or alternatively, if you have the chemical DEADCAT, you could do cycloaddition reactions, and you could also use this as a Michael acceptor, where you just add in a nucleophile, this molecule is super happy to do that. So DEADCAT, I think this is another based one. I think DEADCAT belongs right in S tier. Okay, here we have CP. If you have CP, it's time to disconnect from the internet and go to jail. This is a more electron-rich version of CP without a star. CP with a star is pentamethylcyclopentadienyl, which is an anion. And if you don't have the star, it just has hydrogens where each of these methyl groups would be. This is a ligand, and it's quite often seen in transition metal chemistry. Sometimes inorganic chemists make so-called piano stool complexes with this, and I'll put a picture of one of those on screen now. And they also do the synthesis of these complexes known as tuck-in complexes. I guess we know where inorganic chemists keep their CP. Why don't we put CP into D tier? Because it's a little bit cringe, but it's not too cringe. Next, we have BArF. This stands for Tetrakis 3,5-bis trifluoromethyl phenyl borate. Tetrakis just means that there's four of them. And this is a good anion for salts because it's useful as a very weakly coordinating anion. Some people will say non-coordinating, but this super-duper triggers certain chemists. So there's no such thing as non-coordinating. Some part of the anion will still interact with the cation, so we can only really say it's weakly coordinating. So the effect of this is it makes the cation way more Lewis acidic, which makes it more quote-unquote electrophilic. And I'm getting a phone call. Hold on. Hello?
Your MacBook Pro will be dispatched in the next 12 hours. If you have not made any such purchase or transaction, then kindly press 1 to speak Amazon customer service. Thank you.
That sounds pretty legit, doesn't it? Okay, hopefully there's no more interruptions in the remainder of this tier list. So as I was saying, if you have a cation with BArF, it makes the cation a lot more Lewis acidic than it would normally be. So this means you can do cool reactions that normally wouldn't work. So you could have like the sodium BArF salt deprotect acetals. Normally if you had something like sodium chloride, that wouldn't happen. This is because why? It's not because the BArF doesn't interact with the sodium, it's that it barely interacts with the sodium. And as soon as you see how much this salt costs, you too will BArF. So why don't we put BArF into F tier? Because I think BArF is pretty cringe. Next up, we have DIPT, or DIPT. DIPT is diisopropyltryptamine, and this compound is a tool for studying auditory perception. And Hamilton Morris and Jason Wall have spent over a decade studying it.
Hey, did something happen to the audio? I think it might have dipped.
Why don't we put DIPT into D tier? Because it starts with a D. DOTA. Are you a gamer? This chemical DOTA is an abbreviated form of dodecane tetracetic acid, which isn't a very apt name because it doesn't really describe what this molecule is. It misses all of the nitrogen groups, and the full name is too long. If you want the full name, I'll put it in the description. This chemical is a complexing agent used for lanthanides, which is one of those rows at the bottom of the periodic table people don't usually care about. And when you complex these lanthanides, they have applications as a contrast agent or as certain cancer treatments. And so a contrast agent is like a way to enhance the radio density of a target tissue by altering the way that electromagnetic radiation or ultrasound waves pass through the body. So sometimes this can be useful for imaging. Now, in certain cancer treatments, you might want to be able to get a radioactive isotope somewhere in the body more specifically. And so sometimes people will tether DOTA to monoclonal antibodies. For instance, one example is with yttrium-90, and this concentrates the yttrium-90 in the vicinity of tumor cells. In addition, I saw this other amusing abbreviation on Wikipedia, and I bet that this edit will make some people salty. Why don't we put DOTA into B tier? Because it's not that bad. It's pretty good. Up next, we have CAM, which stands for ceric ammonium molybdate. Yes, much like sulfate, we have molybdate. This complex is really good as a TLC stain for thin layer chromatography. Sometimes if you're separating molecules, you need to visualize where they are. So if you've ever seen some other chemtuber on YouTube do TLC before, oftentimes they'll do stains with CAMNO4, potassium permanganate. But CAM works a lot better because it will react with like most functional groups. Even if you just have like a CH, it can still oxidize and you can still visualize those spots. Super duper useful, and I've never actually seen CAM on camera. So CAM, it's an interesting one. It's not too bad in terms of name. You know, CAM is fine. CAM stain, you know, it's fine. And so I think we just put that into C tier because it starts with a C. Here we have PPI. PPI is inorganic pyrophosphate, and this is formed by the hydrolysis of ATP into AMP, which is adenosine triphosphate into adenosine monophosphate. And while this pyrophosphate can be hydrolyzed in like water, it occurs really slowly. So this is usually fine, except for at really, really low pHs. Despite such a small acronym, PP is actually pretty big. Why don't we put this one into E tier? Because it's kind of cringe. It's kind of cringe. Okay, TEA, triethylamine. This is a really, really common tertiary amine base in organic chemistry. And I hate the smell of triethylamine. This is like a suffocating, rotten fish smell, and it's awful. While its name might be TEA or T, it's the last thing you want to drink. We could put T into F tier because it's a pretty cringe name. Next, we have BCNU. And you might be thinking, hey, that chemist, after all those puns, I think I'm not going to be seeing you anymore. The name for this one is 1,3-bis-2-chloroethyl-1-nitrosourea, aka carmustine. And there's a lot of really cursed functional groups in this molecule. We have a urea, we have mustards, so this is like mustard gas mustards, and we also have an N-nitroso group. This is a very, very cursed molecule. So this chemical is used as a chemical agent for chemotherapy, and it's an alkylating agent, which is why there's two alkylating groups, which are the chloroethyl groups. This might be really effective at treating cancer, so effective that it might even say to the cancer, hey cancer, I'll be seeing you later. We could put this one into F tier. Okay, here we have BABE or PETA. BABE stands for bisacetoxyiodobenzene, and PETA stands for phenyl iodine 3 diacetate. This is a hypervalent iodine 3 oxidant that is frequently seen in organic chemistry. The most common reaction where people see this is for the TEMPO BABE oxidation. And what this does is it reoxidizes TEMPO, which is a catalyst for these oxidations. Oh, PETA, you're such a babe. We could put this one right into F tier. Okay, we have NBA, N-Bromoacetamide. This is an electrophilic brominating agent. It's occasionally used in organic chemistry, and this is a ballin reagent. So why don't we put this one into A tier? Next, we have CAN, also known as CAN, or ceric ammonium nitrate. This is a highly OP oxidant, which is able to do oxidations that would be challenging for more orthodox oxidants, or should I say, orthodoxidants. This even includes CH bonds. Which oxidant will do the job? This one can. And this one can go right into C tier, because it starts with a C. Okay, next we have DUMP, or D-U-M-P. This is deoxyuridine monophosphate, and this is an intermediate in the synthesis of thymidine monophosphate. Your body makes this because you're a dump. This one's kind of dumb. This can go into D tier. Don't ask why. We know why it's in D tier. You know exactly why this one's in D tier. Next, we have FAP. No, not you, silly. Stop it. This is tris-perfluoroalkyl trifluorophosphate, and FAPs have been a component of ionic liquids. And I quote, FAP ionic liquids show an excellent hydrolytic stability, low viscosity, and high electrochemical and thermal stability that makes them attractive for use in electrochemical devices and as a new media for application in modern technologies and chemical synthesis. So I think FAP is 100% going to go into F tier. Plus, with all those fluorines on there, how could we not put it in F tier? Next, we have DAM, diaminomalonitrile. This is a tetramer of hydrogen cyanide, and it has been proposed as a key substance for the prebiotic synthesis of nucleobases. This is part of the quote-unquote chemical evolution. Oh, so that's how prebiotic molecules formed. Damn! This one's awesome. We can put it right into S tier. And last, but not least, we have sodium ethyl xanthate. Some of you wished I'd make the molecules bigger, so I'm going to do that just for you. Here's a nice big sex molecule. So sex is sodium ethyl xanthate. This is used as a flotation agent in the mining industry, and flotation has been described as the single most important operation used for the recovery and upgrading of sulfide ores. The way that this works is this attaches to the surface of sulfide ores like lead sulfide, copper sulfide, and through the action of air bubbles, it carries the ore to the surface. And you might be wondering why this is the last chemical that we're talking about today, and that's because I wanted to finish sex last. Why don't we put this one right into S tier? Which is appropriate, because it starts with an S. So hopefully you've enjoyed this tier list. We have even more tier lists on the channel, some funny, some educational, and you can let me know down in the comments what you think this one was. Thanks for watching, and I hope you have a great day.